Pro Tools finally has Melodyne ARA integration, but it comes at a cost. Is it worth the upgrade? Let's find out. What's up, everyone? I'm Malcolm Owen-Flood, and let's talk audio. AFID recently released version 2022.9 of Pro Tools, and it includes Melodyne ARA integration, which is absolutely amazing and something we've been waiting for a very long time. Or is it? Unfortunately, it comes at a cost. Let's dive into its implementations and see how it works, and if it's worth the upgrade. Now, a quick note. The first version of this ARA integration was 2022.9, and it was an absolute disaster. But luckily, AFID got a new version 2022.10 out just a few days after, and that is what I will be running through with you today. Honestly, don't even give version 2022.9 a chance. It was absolutely terrible. So is the new and more stable version, Pro Tools 2022.10, worth the upgrade? Well, I've got good news and bad news. Let's get into it. Starting with the good, let's jump into it. My favorite thing they've done is how they implemented accessing Melodyne. It's as simple as either selecting a clip you want to edit, which I'm so happy is a possibility. So right now I've just gone and selected a clip on my main vocal here. And you can just right click it, go to Melodyne, and click edit. And what happens is this new window pops up after it analyzes it. It automatically analyzes it, it's very quick. We can see all of our vocal data. If you have a dual monitor display or a big TV like I actually normally have running, it's pretty awesome. You can split them and have them on different screens if you want to. Now I've got all that vocal tuning data for this specific clip visible right in front of me, and I can grab things and drag them around as I would like. Now, alternatively, if I didn't want to just do one clip, I just come over and click on the main vocal or whatever track you want to get Melodyne on, right click it, go down to Melodyne, edit. It will now do the whole song. And that was instantly pretty much. I think even when you select just a clip, I think it ends up scanning the whole song. I'm not totally clear on that, but It's quick either way, and it's so convenient. So now this whole vocal is ready to be tuned. Now you can actually access your Melodyne tab or your clip effects tab, which is a new feature that I'll make a video on as well, right from the bottom of the screen here. And you can just hide it or show it, but it does pop up automatically when you select Melodyne on any track. One of the other great features is if you click options here, there is an option to follow selection in DAW and zoom to selection in DAW. And this is amazing. Something that totally didn't happen before, but I can just grab a section I want to look at and my Melodyne window resizes to show just that information. And if I then click play, it pages over to follow the playback marker inside my Pro Tools session, which is absolutely amazing. Just a lifesaver, so much quicker and more intuitive. In addition, you can even control your playback position from inside of the Melodyne window. You just click up above here, and I will note on my version anyways, it seems like you have to click above this line to make it work, but you just click anywhere, and that is now your playback position. Which is really great because then you don't have to come up to the timeline. You can just stay in Melodyne world and just tune, tune, tune. Super happy about that as well. They also did a really great job at implementing shortcuts. So if you click inside of the Melodyne window, any of their built-in shortcuts start working. For example, I'm often using numbers 1 through 4 to select different controls inside of Melodyne. So all I have to do is click inside of Melodyne and then I can jump around. And if you double click a number, it'll actually jump through the drop-down window options there as well. Incredibly quick. It's changing my workflow significantly. And arguably the best feature is that Melodyne is actually post-clip. That means that you can edit your clip and clip gain things or fade things or whatever you want to do, and that'll automatically reflect in Melodyne. That is not how it used to work. You used to have to rescan it in or render it down and then do your clip edit. And for taking out breaths or squeaks and guitars and stuff like that, it was an absolute nightmare. And those days, I am happy to say, are gone. They're in the past, no longer a problem. Now, this all seems awesome, right? So what about the bad? Well, unfortunately, there is some bad. Let's get into it. The bad thing is that a lot of the good features just randomly stop working. So take the follow zoom, for example. Sometimes you'll select a selection and it just won't reflect on the Melodyne editor. And you have to go manually zoom out inside of Melodyne and go find it just like you used to have to. And it's pretty annoying. Or worse yet, I've actually had it where it is actually just showing me something different. And that is, you know, confusing. It takes you out of it. not great. Additionally, it's also pretty hard to know what track you're looking at inside of Melodyne, so you might think you're tuning one thing, but actually have another track selected. So for example, I just selected a different vocal take, but it's still showing me the info for that lead vocal. And that is because this other vocal I took doesn't have Melodyne enabled, but I just kind of wish that Melodyne would go blank in that case so that it only reflected what I had selected in my timeline. This could potentially lead to some big mistakes. I mentioned earlier in the video that this integration came out in 2022.9, but they quickly updated that because it was so bad. This is kind of a carryover from that problem. What was happening in the previous version is that it was saving and updating this ARA data so often that it was pretty much unusable. You were constantly just getting these little windows popping up, making it impossible for you to actually get work done. So luckily that has been greatly reduced, but it's still kind of a problem. Every once in a while, just a little loading window pops up and it just takes you out of it. And last but not least, I experienced a warning where it just told me that my tracks were corrupted and it just said, check your edits. This is crazy. It doesn't tell me which tracks or where. It just tells me that something went wrong. Hope you find it. It's totally unacceptable in my mind. I couldn't find something. I don't know. It all seemed fine, but it's worrisome. It didn't make me feel good. That's not how your DAW should be. As a good friend of mine said, if you can't trust it, you shouldn't use it. Now, another thing to note, and this isn't really a flaw, but you should know, is that if you have any of the advanced Melodynes and you want to go polyphonic, for example, you have to manually select that. It seems to always default to being melodic, which isn't a problem, and I'm used to that. So just make sure if you're planning to tune polyphonic material that you go and select that manually. So in conclusion, should you upgrade? Well, let's review the good and the bad and summarize it. But first, this video is brought to you by the Self-Recording Band Academy and Podcast. If you want to level up your recording skills and be able to produce professional music from anywhere in the world, you have to go and click the link below in the description to get a free one-on-one coaching call with the owner and founder of the Self-Recording Band, Benedict Hine, where he offers one-on-one coaching with his students. It is the fastest way to level up your recording skills. And you got to check out the Self-Recording Band Podcast as well. I'm a co-host on it and have been since the very beginning. We get it on there every week and talk about DIY recording for bands, getting the results to be super incredible and professional. We've had some wild success with this, so please do join us there as well. All right, let's get back to the video. Should you upgrade to Pro Tools 2022.10 for Melodyne ARA integration? Let's review. First up, the good. Not having to print the data into Melodyne on every track in real time, or even if you use the track freeze hack, which I'll make in another video for you, it's a huge time saver. It's just enormous, and this probably makes it worth it. This of course depends on your workflow, but for me, I think this is why I'm probably gonna keep it and not go back to the previous version, even though there are things that bug me. When you consider that you can also edit the clips and it'll update that ARA data inside of Melodyne automatically, it's just a huge workflow saver for me. Another benefit of the sped up workflow is that it keeps you in a flow state, so if that is something that's important to you, this upgrade is probably worth it. However, there is of course the bad. Unfortunately, the bad list is pretty bad. Depending on your computer speed and seemingly the mood of Pro Tools, this could be unbearable. The hangups that are caused by the ARA saving data updating thing, it's pretty annoying, honestly. And if you value consistency in your workflow above all else, this probably won't work out for you. It just forgets to follow the timeline sometimes, and it's really frustrating because it just works perfectly and then stops for no reason that I can find. And frankly, the corrupted data warning is terrifying. It doesn't tell me anything. It doesn't tell me which track is broken, where I should look. It's just something's wrong in your session. Hopefully you find it. That's pretty unacceptable. Ultimately, I think for me that the pros do outweigh the cons. I like to do a lot of tuning, even polyphonic stuff on guitar DIs and whatnot. I think I can struggle through this. I know it's gonna get better eventually with more updates, but it's not a home run by any stretch. So I hope this video helps you weigh the pros and cons, see what would benefit your workflow specifically, and you can make a decision for yourself. Now, if you don't want to update and you need a hack on how to speed up your workflow with Melodyne in your previous versions of Pro Tools, I do have a video for you. It'll be up in one of these corners. I don't know how to do that yet, so we'll see. And that will show you how you can speed up your Melodyne workflow in previous versions of Pro Tools that don't have ARA integration. Thanks for watching, click subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.